Okay, good.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey, nice to meet you.
I've started.
Actually,
Just in time, how happy are you with that performance, knowing that you're coming back from the struggles?
初めに彼と組んだ時に力負けは絶対にしてないなと感じたので、彼が疲れる疲弊するまで待って、一本狙うような作戦に切り替えてました。
Actually, when I grappled him in the first round, I realized physically there's no way I'm going to lose to this guy, but he was a much superior striker, so I decided to let his gas run out just to see, to play with his cardio, and when I see the opportunity, just to chop him up. That was a strategy.
And it was a big win for you. This time around, you're facing against number five. What is the reason behind this? Because other fighters tend to go up slowly into the ladder, but you jump right into the number five.
No, just this one, かかったのはビッグウィンなんですけども、いきなりそのランキングの上の5位のやるっていうことに関して、少しずつこういかないで、いきなり5位ってやるのはなぜですかっていうのは、それはどう思ってますか？
ジャスティン・スコーキンスはレイボーグに勝ってます。彼は3位に30対27、もう完勝しているので、今回の5位と戦うことも別にジャンプアップとは思ってないです。
Well, first of all, remember, Justin Scoggins beat Ray Borg 30-27 all throughout. That means it's complete domination. The only reason he was not in the rank was he went up to 135 for once and came back. So I feel like I deserve to fight the number 5 guy. So I feel fine.
And how important was that win against Scoggins? Because Scoggins came in saying he thought that it was a career-defining fight for him. So how much did that mean to him?
Scoggins はやっぱりフライキに戻して、それこそが自分のキャリアの一番ターニングポイントに素晴らしい試合になると潰したんだけど、どう思いますか？
いやー、でも彼は多分フライの中でも上に行くと思ってます。かなり強かったので。
Well, you know, I tell you this, Justin Scoggins was a very, very tough fighter. Mm. And I think he's one of the top five in flyweight. He might even go much higher, so that's what it is.
次、ティム・エリオットとやるからね。
And he's fighting Tim Elliott next, right? So he's a tough guy, too.
And my question is, you face Jussi Formiga is a top fiver guy in the division, and do you think it can be tested about your skills to show actually how is your status in UFC to everyone?
フォーミガというのは5位の選手で、まあ、間違いなくタフな選手なので、この選手と戦っていい結果を残すことで、まあ、UFC の自分の位置づけはどういうふうになると思いますか？どう思いますか？
そうですね、フォルミーガはベナビデスにも負けてですね、セジュートにも負けて、レイボーグにも負けて、いい計りになると思ってるんです、今回の戦いが。なんで今回勝って5位になって、確実にタイトルに近づくんで、今回勝ったらやっぱりタイトルマッチを望みたいと
思います。So actually, I think he's a good yardstick for me to see where I'm at. So I think if I beat this guy, I should get a title shot.
素晴らしい強い。
Given with the crazy situation at 125 where every contender is competitive but can't beat Demetrius Johnson, how do you think, would you fare with it?
まあ、フライ級に出場者失敗のに全然 DJ に勝てないじゃないですか。じゃあやるとなったらどうやって勝ちますか？
僕がこの階級に落としたことの理由の一つとして、僕のこの身体的特徴を生かすことがデメトリウスに通用する手段だと思っているので、他の選手ではできないことができると思っています。
First of all, one of the main reasons I came down to flyweight is to utilize my physique and level. Nobody has that kind of physique in flyweight. And that's going to be a big advantage when I fight DJ, Mighty Mouse. So I feel very confident.
And another question is about weight process. You know, we have the problem with Ray Borg in the last minute event. Yeah, that maybe Demetrius is angry about that. But what is your opinion about that process? You know, it's harder to fight or to cut weight and maybe drop the division.
まあ、ベイボーグがこの前失敗して、はい、まあ、ダメになったじゃないですか。でベイミトリーで多分怒ったと思うんですけども、はい、こんなに背高くて、まあ、ウェイトカットとかに関して、まあ、問題がないかっていうのと、どうやってそれをうまくやってるのか、
まあ、内容に関しては秘密なんですけど、まあ、僕ブレイクをかけなきゃ80キロまで持っていける自信があるので、多分フライウェイトの中で一番でかくなれる自信があります。
First of all, I really can't discuss my weight cut method because it's a secret. But I'm telling you this right now, if I really don't make it big myself, I could actually go up to 80 kilo, which is almost close to 185. So nobody in the flyweight has that kind of potentials or physiques. So that's your answer. That's my answer to you.
And my last question is about Formiga also. What is your opinion about his skills? And we know you not tell to us, but do you have a strategy to get the win and show you are a top contender? You want to title shot?
まあ、フォーギー・ミガの、まあ、取ってこともあるとかいろいろしてると思うけど、まあ、それはまずどう思うかということと、まあ、話せる範囲でいいからどういった戦法で
戦法について話せないんですけど、彼の印象としてはやっぱり BJJ がすごい強い、多分フライウェイトの中でもかなりのトップレベルにある、BJJ の持ち主ということと、やっぱりストライキングができるので、僕の中でやっぱりコンプリートファイターに近いですね。
Unfortunately, I can't really share the game plan, but my impression for me, guys, he's one of the top BJJ guys in flyweight division, and he can also strike hard. So he's actually really close to one of the best completed all-round fighter. That's my impression.
Yeah. What about fighting in Japan? Is it easier or harder for him to fight in front of a hometown crowd? Because in Singapore, I suppose there's less pressure on you from family and friends and from being, you know, representing Japan. So
どうですか、日本で試合するということは、日本の家族とか友達とかいろんな人の前で試合しますよね。でこの前はシンガポールだから、そういう人たちが少なかったんで、そういった場合、どっちの方がプレッシャーを感じるのかということを、どういうふうに思ってますか、日本の方々に関して。
僕は別にそこまで感じてないな。 USC はやっぱり全世界で戦うことが義務付けられているので、その全世界のファンに対して、伝えたいという気持ちはどこにいても変わらないです。
Actually, I don't really think about that so much because UFC is a world league and we're mandatory to fight for any country they want us to fight. So I wanted to please the fans all over the world, not only in Japan. So the way I approach my fight is the same everywhere I go.
And one last question. You know, the scenario of MMA has changed. If you see right there, you have a Takanori Gomi. He had a long career. He's a legend of the sport. But now, I believe Japan is looking for a new stars, a new fighters. Do you think you can be part of that? You show not only for around the world, of course, but especially here in Japan, you can show your skills and to the public, show your personality and impress the public.
日本の MMA ってここ数年です大きく変わったと思うんですよ、まあ、そこにいるゴミさん見て分かるように昔は強かったけどなかなか難しいところがありまして、でこれから日本の MMA はニュースターが必要だと思う、はい、でその自分がそのニュースターになれる、まあ、特に日本のチャンスだと思ってます。でどういうのそういうことがどうか
僕自身スターになりたいとか思ってなくて、チャンピオンになりたいので、そういうものは僕じゃなくて周りが決めることなので後からついてくると。
Well, I don't really think about being a star fighter. I only think about being a champion. And once I became a champion, people around me will make a decision who's the star. So being a star will follow behind when I start became a champion.